Thank you very much for inviting me to speak. Is my voice clear? Today I will start with a small, short story of how a good believing Christian king was receiving Muslim refugees in Abyssinia. And when they came to him, at the first immigrant in Abyssinia, the Qurayshite sent behind them somebody to try to break the relationship between the refugees and the good believing Christian king. But because he wanted to build the relationship between both himself and them on trust, respect, dialogue, and transparency, he led them to speak about the religion. And they spoke about the story of Lady Mary the Virgin, and they read to him, and he accepted their argument, and he led them to live freely in his country as citizen, not as refugees. And this is the universal call to the people in Europe and America to accept refugees as citizens coming from Syria, from Somalia, from any part of the world. Not to come like refugees. My intervention would be divided into a few points, fundamental principles, common shared values, unity of humanity, how can we develop new values, and how can we build partnership between us? In the first part, I'll be talking about something from the text, universal messages. As you can see, the first slide talk about people are equal. The only difference between X and Y and Z is what they believe in and their piety. And the only one who understands and see piety is God himself, not me and you. This is talk about the children of Israel in the book. This was a message to them by Allah. whoever saved a soul, he is as he saved all of humanity. And whoever killed a soul, I think he has killed the whole humanity. It was addressed to the children of Israelites. The teaching of Jesus and Muhammad of the same, love thy neighbor, without knowing who is the next door neighbor. Whether it's a Muslim or a Christian, black or white, short or tall, whatever it is, but love thy neighbor and respect thy neighbor. When we help people, it's a declaration, or desire, we help them out of love, not out of joy. Even the captives, the prisoners of war, we serve them because we love the service, to serve God, not because it's a job described or job description. Because the reward is, we don't want a reward from you as a minister or a prime minister, because you are actually seeking the reward from God. It's out of our love when the needy, the orphan, and the captives of the prisoners of war. We talked yesterday about the Ten Commandments. It's mentioned in the Old Testament. It's mentioned also in the Holy Quran. In both of them, and you have the same as the Ten Commandments, as you can see them, we agree with all of them, and also it was mentioned in the Quran next slide. Life, wealth, and neglect, teaching for us, and this is how Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, taught us to follow the teaching of Jesus, peace be upon him. This is actually the theological part of it. Now we go to something else. Can we go together? Let's go. We talked yesterday about the third one. About commonly shared values. You look at these three images. The one in blue is my individual principle. The one on the right is your individual principle. You have to respect. I respect your privacy, your individual principle, and you respect mine. But in the middle, which is the majority, is the commonly shared value. When you look at both of them, that the majority of what we have is commonly shared. When we start respecting one another, then agreeing on our differences, we can develop this green in the middle, which is newly developed values. Newly developed values would be only developed when we start to share our commonly shared value and respect one another. It's not just something we get some people to speak about it. It's something we come out of our partnership working together. Next. This is another thing which is, we mentioned about the Ten Commandments, and we mentioned about the five, five fundamental Islams and fasting Sharia. What is the difference? It's very minimal, but some of our teachers are criticizing our religion, are criticizing our religion, or some of our teachers are ignorant of our culture and our shared values. But they don't look at the society as a whole. They look at their own sect, their own society, not the greater society. So this is coming to us because of the political desire of the leaders, could be driven by the political decision of one country or another. The new material values, which were mentioned about it, we have to respect our differences, have to agree on our One of the first fundamental of this, no, I'm somebody who is very funny. I can say to you, Old MacDonald has a farm in Arabic. His Royal Highness has a farm, E-A-E-O. Okay, and you can sing with me. This is my acronym. The fundamental for partnership is to plant a tree. The tree is trust, respect, engage, and empower. Is the fundamental for our partnership. We have to trust one another, then we have to respect one another, then engage in the work and empower one another. These three will bear fruits. One of them is the third kiss. I give you the third, you give me the kiss. Okay, she knows now. It is the relationship between the donor countries, the international organization, and the local organization. The international organization has to fundraise. Advocate and train. The local organization has to provide the knowledge-based, sustainable, innovative, sustainable solution. And here, the partnership is equal footage. Not because you have the money, but you are better than me. But because I'm in Africa and in Europe and America, and you have the money, that you are better than me. No. My know-how is as good and precious as your money. So this kind of focus has to be built on equal footages. We are equal as local community and the international community. This is the first fruit of our tree. The second fruit, I call it a hope. Our humanitarian partnership should be based on alternative, operational engagement. Alternative, operational engagement. If you want really to build partnership, between local communities in Africa, in Asia, in Latin America, and others, we have to find all the time alternative ways of our operational engagement. Money is not a solution. Money is a part of the solution, but the operational engagement between the international